Almost lakhs of students are waiting for this particular notification, especially in West Bengal. And this notification is popularly known as notification for Assistant Engineer Civil, which is a post recruited by Public Service Commission, West Bengal, for different department. So without wasting time, let's see the important features of this special notification. Okay, so first you have to go wbpsc.gov.in/whatsnew.jsp. There at the very first or at the very top, you will get this advertise name. Advertisement for recruitment to the post of Assistant Engineer Civil in various department of government of West Bengal. Okay, so what is the advertisement? This is your advertisement here at the very first. It is mentioned that this is the advertisement for the recruitment in this particular department. The very first one is your Public Works Department or PWD. Second one is Irrigation and Waterways. Third one is Public Health Engineering. And last one is PNRD or Panchayat and Rural Development Department. So to recruit the assistant engineers in this force department, the Public Service Commission of West Bengal are going to conduct an examination, which is known as the examination for recruitment to the post of assistant engineers in civil. Okay. First one is, what is the pattern of this examination? Well, the examination will be held in two successive parts. First one will be your written examination, which is a MCQ based question. There is no objective paper or objective written paper. All are based on MCQ type. And second part is, after shortlisting based on these MCQ type questions or written examination, you will have to appear for an interview. Okay, and this examination will be held in Kolkata only, and that will be done in the month of November of this year or 2020. So if this is July, you have only August, September, October and November, 3 to 4 months for preparing this particular examination. Okay, so now let's see what are the salary scale and other qualification criteria, etc. So first one is, this is pay level 16. That means it is the revised pay scale in West Bengal government, and the starting salary will be almost 56,100 and plus 12 or 15% HRA. That means at the time of joining, you will get almost 64,000 in your hand. Okay, and there is no mention about the vacancies, but I can tell you that as per the latest news which has been published in different newspaper in Bengal, there are lots of vacancies in PWD and Irrigation Department, especially in PWD, because this department has been restructured and lots of new post has been created. So I think you have nothing to do with the vacancies. You will have to give your best and the rest will be taken care of by the authority. Now come to the qualification criteria. What should be the qualification criteria for appearing in this particular examination? The essential qualification is that you have to be graduate in civil engineering from any recognized university or equivalent qualification. This equivalent qualification referred to the degree which are given by your Institute of Engineers in India, or the degree which is known as AMI. And the second criteria is, this is very much important, and this criteria is mainly checked during your interview process. That is, as you are going to serve the Bengal, you have to be able to read, write and speak in Bengali. Okay, and if your mother tongue is Nepali, in that case these are exempted for you. Especially the student who apply from Bihar or Odisha, they have to prepare, or they have to keep in mind this point, that they prepare themselves to speak, read and write in Bengali. Okay, and especially for candidates who are going to apply for PHE and PNRD or Public Health Engineering and Panchayat and Rural Development Department, it is desired by the commission that they have 1 year's postgraduate practical training or study or research, okay, or 1 year engineering experience, practical engineering experience. Now come to the age criteria. Well, for general category or unreserved category, you should not be more than 36 year old, or you should not be born earlier than 2nd January 1984. Okay, and if you belongs from SC, ST or OBC category, OBC for OBC obviously it should be non-criminal. Okay, in that case you will have 5 years of concession for SC and ST. That means 36 plus 5, that is 41 years old. And for non-criminal OBC, you will have 3 years extra concession. That means you should be below 39 years. Okay, and if you have more than 40% physical disability, in that case you have 45 years age limit to appear in this examination. Now come to the mode of application. There is no scope for offline application. You can only apply through online mode only. Okay, and it is mentioned that submission of more than one application by the same candidate, it's strictly forbidden. Okay, so keep in mind that you should not submit more than two application. What is the fee for application? Well, this is a very nominal fees, that is 210 only. Okay, and if you are belong forms ST or ST category or person with disability, in that case you are not required to any fee. You are totally exempted. Now come to the examination center for written examination. Well, there is only single examination center or single region, that is Kolkata. There is no other cities where this exam will be held. Now let's see the important topic. Well, the starting of this online application is 14th July. Okay, so you have roughly half a week to start this application process, and the closing date is 6th August. Okay, this is most important. Before this date or the 6th August 2020, you have to complete your online application. Well, that's all about your important point about the application. Now let's see what are the examination system or how the examination will be conducted. As I have already told that there are two parts of this examination. First part is written examination and second one is interview. Okay, and in written examination you will have to answer total 100 questions which will carry total 200 marks, and the duration of this paper will be 2 hours. That means you will have 120 minutes for solving 100 questions. Okay, and this interview will be of 100 marks. Now what is the syllabus for this written examination or interview? Well, as the essential criteria or essential qualification for appearing in this examination is that you have to be graduate in civil engineering from any college. So the syllabus of this written examination or interview is totally based on the syllabus of graduation. Okay, as you can see here, this is theory and design of structure. There are solid mechanics or strength of materials, that is known to you as SOM. Then structural analysis, steel design, RCC design or concrete design. Then fluid mechanics, hydraulics, soil mechanics, everything which are related to or which you have already studied in your college, all are included in this syllabus. Survey, construction, material, practice planning or BMC, which is popularly known as BMC. Then highway engineering and water resource engineering, that means hydrology and your irrigation engineering. And finally, your environmental engineering. So the whole syllabus which you have already covered in your graduation or in your college degree, that is going to be repeated here also. Okay, now here you can see that total 100 questions which will be asked in your written examination. Okay, obviously now this is the notification in 2020 and previous notification was in your 2015. Okay, so after almost 5 years this notification has been published. So if you think that the student who have passed in 2015, they have already applied or selected in this examination, then also you have total 4 batches, 2016, 17, 18, 19, 4 batches, and it is very much possible that the batches before 2015 are also going to appear for this examination. Okay, and it is quite obvious that all of the students or all of these candidates are already employed somewhere, either they are working in private sector or they are taking their higher degrees. Okay, so it is not possible for them to cover this vast syllabus again or to revise this vast syllabus again within these 3 or 4 months. Okay, so naturally you ask, so what are the important topic or what is the shortcut? Okay, so for that my suggestion is go to the department, okay, for which departments they are going to recruit you or for which department they are going to conduct this examination. Okay, so first one is PWD. What are the different type of works done in PWD? Or the next department is irrigation and waterways. What are the works normally done in this type of department? Or the public health engineering. What are the works, what are the scope of works which are done in this type of department? Okay, if you go through the website of this type of this department, you will get familiar with the different type of jobs from where, from the different tenders. Okay, from there it will be very clear to you that in PWD especially the road works, the building works are done. Okay, in public health engineering, they are mainly related with your water supply, water treatment, water supply system, like that. Okay, if you go to the irrigation and waterways, they are normally interested or they normally do works related to your canal, river, etc. Okay, so from this type of department and from their ongoing works, you will be get familiar with which type of jobs or which type of works normally they do. So naturally the commission who are conducting this examination for recruiting candidates who will work as an assistant engineer in those department would be able to solve those problem. Okay, so for that my suggestion is first go there and look after which type of works are going there. And I may suggest you that normally the question asked, especially in 2015, as I already appeared in 2015 and has been selected. So my suggestion is normally question has been asked in 2015 from environmental engineering. A lots of question has been asked from this particular topic. Okay, environmental engineering, and next one is your highway engineering. And the reason is clear, because the PWD works are normally related to your roads and buildings. That's why highway engineering is carry your a good marks, and next is your environmental engineering. Okay, then comes to your water resource engineering. Why? Because they are related to your irrigation and waterways department. Okay, so if you think that you have very limited time and you don't have that much of time to prepare yourself for this type of examination, so my suggestion is give priorities especially these three subject. First one should be environmental engineering. Okay, second one should be your highway engineering, and last one should be water resource engineering. After completing all these topics or subjects, if you have time, okay, in that case go to your soil and surveying. Okay, and then again if you have time, look after the RCC. Trust me, they normally would not ask you questions from theory of structure or strength of materials, which we normally civil engineers give more emphasis. Okay, so wish you best of luck, prepare yourself, and please let me know if you have any problem on any topic. I will cover that in my channel.